It's time to roast. It's time for the Royal Roast. Participants include Rockin' Robert Vino, the loud, lovely Lola Dolores, Hector the Jailbird Choppa, Fantastic Frankie the Colorblinder, Double Dragon Twin Bobby Banda, Oscar the Fish Hernandez, Marvelous Martin the Kid, and the Roast Master, Joe Cool the Greaser. It's every man for themselves in the Royal Roast, plus special guests. And then, of course, the Roast of Honor, Nick Rogers. It's time to roast the Royal Roast of Nick Rogers.
Welcome, everybody, the Royal Roast of Nick Rogers. Yeah, y'all gotta clap. Y'all can't just stand like, you know, fools. Anyway, all right, silence. I just want to say welcome to everybody. Not good night because it's not ended yet. And we're going to roast the motherfucking shit out of this white fucking cocksucker. Shut up, Nick. You'll get to say something at the end. Fuck. Anyways, our following roasties are Robert Vino, the Scarhead. We got Martin, the guy right here next to my left. Y'all can see him. Son of a bitch, shut the fuck up. Marvelous Martin, the Kid of Roscoe. Yeah. Give it up for that guy. Where's Oscar? Okay, shut the fuck up, god dang. We got Oscar the Fish Hernandez. That motherfucker's been trying to call me the fish forever. Fuck that motherfucker. We got Hector the Jailbird Choppa Trevino. And we got Bobby Banda in the building. Yeah, he is gonna roast. He's not an ornament, shit. Who else? Other brother, Fantastic Frankie the Colorblinder Trevino. Am I missing anybody? Who's the other motherfucker? Oh, and that motherfucker Sergio,
R.I.P.
Oh, shit. My fucking board just went blank. Technical difficulty, sorry. Florentino the Caveman Choppa will be... Oh, well, he's not here either. Damn it. Everybody wanted Melvin the Martian, but, you know... You know how, you know, that nigga is, sure. Who else do we got? Oh, we got, yeah, thank you. Thank you, audience member that I don't know.
Who are you?
Shit, sorry, this fucking thing's fucking going. Where the fuck is my thing? Hey, shove it, boy, shove it. Damn, this sucks really. I fucking wiped out my whole board in one touch. Technology, right? Ladies and gentlemen? Intermission. We'll be back after these following messages. We're back on, guys. Thank you. And I am Joe Cool the Greaser, your motherfucking roast master. Man, that's a long-ass applause, you motherfuckers. Anyways, our first roaster will be Robert, what do you call yourself? Where the fuck is he at? Rockin' Robert. I guess he changed his name all of a sudden. He's a rapper part-time, and he's a bitch on the other time. Rockin' Robert!
Rub the Buddha. Well, Nick, are you looking? Do you got eyes behind your head? Because I swear those eyes don't ever connect when I'm looking straight at you. Nick, how many times do you cut your head when you shave it, dude? Because I see like a war going on. Shut the fuck up. We don't care. Well, Nick, it's a pleasure roasting you, and
that was short, fucker.
That's myself.
Yay. Everybody give it up for Rockin' Robert, the rapper. Okay, I forgot who was the next roaster. Shit, I drank a little too much. Oh, Hector T. Choppa. I know, shit, shut the fuck up. I know this guy because, well, he's my fucking cousin, okay? I had no fucking choice to know this motherfucker, okay? This guy, but, you know, after, I don't know.
Wait,
sorry, I don't have a sound effect for that. Anyways. Fucking Nick always laying an egg all the time. Anyways, we got Hector T. Choppa, the Jailbird Trevino, and he's up next. Give him a round of applause. Clap your fucking hands, you bitch. Oh wait, hold on. Intermission. I want to introduce a new person that just stepped in, like she always does, Dolores Trevino.
Nick, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Everybody's favorite bitch. They love to pick on you, always and forever. You need some Vaseline for your asshole. I say you need some Vaseline for your asshole. Did Joe use it all up on you?
Huh? Wait, hold on. Okay.
Go. Man, y'all are whack. Really? Really? Give me that goddamn thing. No. Yeah, but there's a lot of old motherfuckers up in here. Damn, we're getting up there.
Yeah.
Shit. Many years and so many memories too that like just going away because of Alzheimer's.
GYC?
Yes, songs of Alzheimer's.
I fucked up my soundboard, god dang it.
Oh, womp womp womp. Joe, you're not technical, dude. Just face it, you're old.
Yeah.
This
Aol.com, nigga.
My kids don't know what that is. Really? What? Oh yeah. Oh look, y'all like my sign?
What?
For purchase here at Oscar's Creative Workshop.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hello. The epitome. Look at that. The coldest woman right here. I'm taking this home. I'm gonna put it over my bedroom door. Hell yeah. When? Oh, hating ass nigga. You mad, bro? Are you mad, bro? Are you mad, bro? No, because Joe, oh, come on now, y'all can all agree with me that Joe is the one that would sit here and talk shit about everybody. Everybody. Yeah, just wait till next year when it's your birthday. But no, Nick, I mean, I can't really talk shit about Nick because, I mean, everybody has. Everybody always talks shit about Nick, and he takes it, and he's always there. He's a good guy, you know. But all you other motherfuckers, Hector, you're my brother. I'm supposed to hate you, but you're an asshole. Seriously. Martin, speak up, nigga. Speak up. You're still quiet, fucker. And let me see.
That's true.
Frankie, lay off the video games. Bobby, can't find you because you're too short. And Oscar. Oh, god damn, you're just a hot mess, nigga. Hot mess. You were the quietest one back then. Now, like, it's like, what the fuck? But, yeah. Y'all still some crazy bitches. Yeah. All the crazy bitches, though. What? Do it again.
Oh, that's time's up. Fuck
yeah.
That. Keep on going.
So, let me give the mic back to this dumbass right here. See what else he has to say. Yeah. Boo! Who wants him back?
Thank you, Dolores Trevino. Very controversial and probably. Yeah, very controversial. Dolores Trevino. Let's give her another round of applause. You know what? Fuck that bitch. All right, let's go on to the real roast. That was Kitty time. Now it's time to go with the J-O-E time to insult the fuck out of Nick. I said insult the fuck out of Nick. Shit. God dang, she was dogging me all day. It's not about the J-O-E, shit. Motherfuck. The fuck's wrong with her? It must be that time of the month. Anyways, we got our next roaster. His name is Hector Chapa Trevino, the Jailbird. Give him a round of applause, bitches.
Everybody, welcome to Oscar's Pub, Oscar's Woodworks my ass. Oh, this looks like garbage around here. Hey, seriously, I didn't write anything down. I'm gonna wing it, unlike this jackass over here with three pages of fucking bullshit. Oscar, what the fuck you laughing at? He look at him running away like a little girl. He's all shy. Don't want to say nothing. What the fuck you laughing at, Joe? You little fucking troll. Hey, I'm just gonna talk shit. Y'all are gonna talk shit about me, right, Nick? Right, Nick? Shut the fuck up. Good Lord, Bobby, where the hell you been? Look at you, way back there. You're not. You're supposed to be up here with everybody else. You're hiding
right,
back there.
Right.
We can't even see you behind Robert. Shut the hell up, Robert. Anyway, this roast is all about Nick. Shut the fuck up so I can say something here, Nick. You're always talking. You never shut up. Good Lord. Hey, if I rub your head, do I get any good luck? Anyway, that was not that funny. I just want to talk about how good of a friend you've been. And, you know, really? We don't want to be talking about sucking. Because Nick sucks all the time. Anyway, I have a... Fuck you, Joe. You little fucking midget. Let me fucking talk shit about this fucking basketball head looking motherfucker right here. I can't even concentrate with you and your bullshit right here. Anyway, I can't do this.
All right, just wrap it up.
No, seriously. Seriously. Shut. You shut up with you and your wrestling bullshit. You always get your ass kicked. Anyway.
Hector, yeah. I know you don't know how to wrap it up, but do it now.
Oh. Was that a remark about all my kids? At least I know how to use my thing. Anyway, Nick doesn't. As you can tell, it's hard for him to find a girlfriend.
Oh, yeah?
Well, he's got him one now, but it took him a long time of looking at guys.
Hey, I saw you, but you were ugly.
Hey, don't make me bring up the clubs. Yeah, you're a pretty good dancer, Nick. So are the guys you were dancing with. No, seriously. Nick's a real good guy. He's a real good friend. Probably the best friend we'll ever have. So that's all I got to say. Thanks, Nick. All right. Good job, Hector. Good job, Jailbird. Good job. All right, for our next roaster, who's the next motherfucker up now? Shit, it's like a draw of hats and shit. Oh, Bobby Banda. Bobby Banda in the building. All right, this guy, I met him back in the day when, you know, when he was a twin. Now he's not a twin or some shit like that. But, yeah, he was a pretty good guy back then, and now he's a double dragon twin. Give him a round of applause, Bobby Banda.
Woo! Are you going to do your technology there for a minute? All right, look, Nick, I'm not prepared. All I got to say is that they told me we were roasting you, and I was like, do I bring the apple? You know what? You guys are right. I'm looking over here. He has like a 5-letter page saying jokes, and it all says Nick. I will say this, though, Nick. I didn't want to roast you due to the fact because we always roast you, no matter if it's your birthday or not. You're always the pig in our eye, all right?
Well, actually, I'm kind of taking a peek over there my magnifying glass. Since we had Dolores say where Odin got Alzheimer's. But if you can see, Nick got some Ballsheimer's. Like I said, very, very unscripted. And I don't care what anybody says about Oscar's layout here. To me, it's a big clubhouse with no tree. Okay? Okay, y'all talking about Hector the Jailbird. If anybody ever noticed, he actually came in with cuffs and now they're off. Did anybody see that? I will say this, though, Nick. You surprised me when you told me you had a woman. And I said, wait a minute. Was that a woman or a woman? And I will feed off another thing Dolores said. Yes, I am short, but if you look around, everybody looks like an Oompa Loompa tonight. I'm going to have to say the only tallest people here probably are women, since they're the ones that wear the pants.
Oh, he's on a roll. He's on a roll.
And since Jell's been kind of a cookie and everybody over here roasting us, I'm going to say I did come up with that he looked like the Mexican Terminator, and I will feed off he wanted a piece of chocolate for the Oompa Loompa. Give the dog a treat. I think the only person I really can't roast, and I hate to say it, if I had a man crush, it would be my boy Frankie. He's done me no wrong, but I will tell you this. He got me into gaming. He got me into Xbox, and I was always a PS fan. And I will say this. Love the guy for everything. He's like a brother, and that is my other twin. Yeah, I got it.
Yeah. That's a good job, Bobby. Good job. Surprisingly. You didn't have, oh, what the hell? That's like a coat slap. Good job. Damn, if I wasn't drunk, I would have been offended. Anyways, we got a next roaster. Which one we got left? We got Frankie, Fantastic Frankie, the Color Brinder. Oscar the Fish. You better start drinking, god dang it. Okay. So we have a brave soul. Welcome, Fantastic Frankie, the Color Blinder.
All right. So I don't really have much, but maybe we can, do some old stories of Nick. Some, horror stories. All right, let's see, which one should we do? There's so many. Okay, you know what? We're going downtown. Let's see, we got Martin, we got Yvette in the car, we got Isabel, Nick, myself. So yeah, we're driving around. This guy, I don't know what he does. He pisses everybody off. He pisses everybody off. So you know what? We vetoed Nick out of the car. Downtown Houston, right? And okay, let's kick him out, whatever, my car, whatever. We kicked him out, and then I was like, we drove off, and then we're like, oh, fuck. We just left Nick off in Houston by himself. Let's go try to pick him up. So then we try to go around. We're looking around. We're like, what the fuck? He's not anywhere to be around. What the hell? Is he hiding or something? So then we go, fuck it, We're just like, let's go to our normal spot. We're just going to go eat and, just see what happens from there. So we go to Taco Cabana. Lo and behold, it's like a stray dog. This motherfucker shows up there. We're like, what the fuck? So we're like, how the fuck did you get here? He's like, well, it's kind of a long story. What happened was I hitchhiked with some people, and they were some weird kind of people, but, I got here. I thought y'all would be here. We're like, are you fucking stupid? He's like, I was kind of hungry, so, yeah. Yes, Nick. You're so, so great of a person. Well, that's all I got as a story, but I'm sure we got plenty more stories from there.
All right. Good job, Fantastic Frankie, the Color Blinder. Watch out. He'll blind your fucking ass. Let me say something, man. All right. What, are you going to roast next?
I want to say something. Audience. Y'all need to get into it. Y'all need to fucking clap your ass off. Come on, man.
First time and won't be the last time, motherfucker. That will be a 2015.
Hey, you know how hard it is? do y'all know how hard it is to come up here and roast somebody? All y'all gotta do is fucking clap. So come on, man, get into it and fucking clap your ass off.
Shake your ass, make your ass fucking clap. All right, for our next roaster, I think we got everybody. Shit, who else we got left? Oscar Hernandez. You know what? We have a special guest. Unfortunately, they couldn't make it, but they did do a video. So let's check it out. This is a special guest. They want to say a hello to you. A special message from The Rock.
What do you want to say?
Well, when Nicholas was born, he pissed me off.
Yeah.
Because he pissed in my face. He's been pissing me off ever since.
I know, that's right.
And then when he was a little boy, he got bit by her dog, and he hated animals. We took him to the zoo, and he screamed and cried.
Oh, yeah, man.
He cried. He hated. We get him any animal we could, and he cried and screamed. And we got him a one-eyed dog, and we went to Big Ben, and the dog left.
Right.
The dog got pissed off and left.
Yeah, right.
As far as Nicholas, he's the only one I know that puts Thousand Islands dressing on scrambled eggs. Gets fucked up and puts ketchup on his pancakes. Gets drunk and passes out in the middle of the damn street in his car. And then he gets drunk and passes out nude in the bathroom while I'm trying to take a piss. Nothing says I love you like fuck you, Dad. Yeah, Marie used to leave her Kotex on his bed.
Okay.
She would leave her little Kotex, bloody Kotex, on his pillow, underneath his pillow.
He
really doesn't like feminine products that much.
Yeah, he don't like that kind of stuff.
If I had two daughters, I'd have shot one of them. I only have one now, so it's all...
Yeah.
Well, I have Nicholas. There's no replacing Nicholas, you know. Nobody texts, drives, and hits somebody in the ass end, you know. An undocumented worker, and the guy gets $1 million.
Yeah.
Hey, Nick brought the truck home, and I wanted to slap him, but I said, number one, this is my drinking hand. Number two, it's going to hurt like hell. And number three, it ain't going to fix the truck. So we just let that go with that.
Yeah, I know that's fine.
But as long as anybody I've known, no one ever gives somebody a cell phone and takes a swim in the Gulf of Mexico.
Right?
Yeah. Salt water, not good on cell phones.
Remember one time or not, we were trying to throw him out of the...
No, we evicted him.
Yeah.
He would never leave.
He would never leave.
Now, Marie left. We were pouting our eyes.
Yeah.
But he wouldn't leave, so me and my brother-in-law grabbed up his shit, threw it.
Man, we got
him. He ran down.
We had him
evicted. We moved him over to Orange Square. Best damn thing we ever had. I mean, best night's sleep we ever had. He used to stay up and watch the Rockets at 12 o'clock at night. He never did his homework. He never got a high school diploma for 4 years after he went to the prom.
Yeah.
He got a high school diploma.
Yeah.
You know, but that's about it, you know.
Yeah.
He still believes in the Rockets. He writes everything on the walls.
Yeah.
He comes over and writes everything. All the phone numbers I have in the garage he had for girls, he cock-blocked them. He covered them all up.
Yeah.
So I can't get any number off
them. I know, that's right.
It's in Klingon.
Yeah, it's in Klingon numbers.
I can't score. He's a cock blocker. You want to say anything, words of wisdom to Mr. Rock? Pay that 2014 Saturn off. If you ever get the keys to it, I'll be surprised.
Right.
I don't even think you'll be able to walk past it.
Yeah, I don't know what else to say.
I don't think you'll be able to change the radio station.
No.
Nick's the only person I know that would rather pay his phone bill and skip a card number. He loves Manwich.
He loves Manwich.
You can cook Manwich and shit together.
Oh, my God.
And feed it to him. He'd eat it.
He loves
Manwich.
Okay.
I just hope he lets us know when he has the baby.
Right. Yeah. I know, that's right.
I guess that's about it.
5 hours later.
Maybe next year, I'll probably make you kick next year.
No. We'll go to Kroger in the back when they throw them out. We'll get you one there.
I'll just get you a cupcake.
If we don't find anything else in the dumpster that has been lately happening.
Yeah, right.
We're just be lucky that we didn't leave you in the dumpster.
Yeah, right.
We believe you were switched at birth. We hope you stay at Star Sailor's Furniture or or Star Stainless or Star whatever furniture company. So you can work a lot of weekends.
Yeah.
Make that money. Work that weekend.
Work those weekends.
Just forget about Star Stainless Crew Company.
Yeah.
Because after all, I mean, you blew it there. Nobody borrows toilet paper. Especially from the job.
Right. I mean, you when somebody tells you to do something, just do it.
Take out the trash.
Yeah, take out the trash. Do what you gotta do, man. Hey, I know you don't like it, but you gotta do some of these things, man.
Well, you're in a better place. You're in a better place.
Yeah.
You think of it, you got weekends to work now. Yeah. You know what?
Yeah.
Might drop some of that weight.
So in the long run, I don't think I'm gonna make you a cake for a while, Nicholas. Maybe I'll just get you a cupcake. That's it.
Get him a gift that keeps on giving. A pregnant female cat. Don't worry about your back bedroom. Because I can tell you what it looks like.
It's got a lot of junk on
it. Looks like shit. You're too lazy. You want to unpack your boxes. They've been there for 8 months. Don't try to get a bed because after all, you used to fall on the floor anyway. When you got a mattress on the floor, at least wise, you won't pass out and roll out and fall on the damn floor. So don't worry about a bed. You're fine just the way you are.
He's doing just fine, so you just keep up to
save your money, stay up at 2 o'clock in the morning on the internet talking to people that don't give a shit about you in person.
That's why we didn't celebrate your birthday, because, you didn't want to.
But it's okay. I try to celebrate it every day.
I
celebrate your birthday every day, son.
That's why we didn't fire the cannon, because... I don't want my friends coming.
Take care of your sister. Take care of your sister because she's going to take all your money now.
Yeah.
Since you're walking lopsided, since you got that money from Pepsi, you're walking lopsided. Your sister's going to be on you like a fly on shit.
Oh, that's right. Yeah.
So watch after it. She's a man killer. She's a car killer. She's a man killer. But that's your sister.
Yeah. So don't expect no more cake from us, right, Nixon? Maybe
she's not going to make you a cake. She's told you that 5 times already.
Yeah.
So I believe you've got that.
Yeah. So just this pure little cupcake is all you're going to get. So that's it. So anyway, this is your mom and dad saying, signing off. Have a nice night, son. And we love you and Sandra. And good luck with this video.
Good enough.
Get your ass over here. You had your ass. Why are you crying like a little bitch? Why are you crying? Damn, this motherfucking guy. What a fucking pussy. I mean, just because, I guess the truth hurts or what? Anyways, we have one last roaster, and now he's bitching and complaining. But this motherfucker got like 18,000 pages of literature to read off of. I think he brought a book or something from Amazon.com. And now he's here to roast the shit out of Nicholas Charles Rogers after his fucking parents handed your ass to him. Give a round of applause for Marvelous Martin, the Kid of Roscoe.
Hello.
All right, I don't know how I can follow after your dad, especially after he made you cry, but... Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and Nick. First off, let's give it up for your hostess, the J-O-E. He calls himself the J-O-E because he's proud. He's proud of the only word he can spell. I've known Joe since he was, I guess the same height because he hasn't grown. The man only grows outward. But he's very sensitive about his height, so don't tease him because he'll punch you in the knee. Joe, it's good to see that you're saving money on shampoo. I knew Joe when he had wavy hair. Now his hair is just waving goodbye. I mean, men are supposed to be tall, dark, and handsome. But Joe's a rebel. He's short, pale, and ugly. All right, this is fun. Everyone's here. There's Oscar and Whoopi Goldberg. Oh, I'm sorry, that's Hector. I just saw the yellow teeth. Hector used to be dark and stinky, but now he's the opposite. He's stinky and dark. He's so dark, African kids send him 50 cents a day. I mean, how am I supposed to roast charcoal? Look at him. He has the face of a saint, Bernard. Hector, you have no idea how ugly you are, do you, man? I know you don't, because every time you look in the mirror, your reflection ducks. All right, well, and then here's Nick, the guest of honor. Let's give it up for Nick. Come on, it's his birthday. Nick, I'm glad you could be here tonight. Sandra, thank you for leaving this cage open. Now, this is to celebrate Nick's birthday, all right? Nick, how old are you in human years? Hey, Nick, didn't your parents ever teach you to look people in the eye when they're talking to you? I'm over here, man, not over there. I mean, I've heard of a lazy eye, but yours looks like it's collecting unemployment. Yeah. I mean, you're so cockeyed. If Ronnie Dangerfield were alive, he'd make fun of you. All right, I got more eye jokes here, so hold on, people. All right, it must be nice, though, when you're driving. You know, you're able to look straight ahead and your blind spot at the same time. But, Nick, we go way back. From high school, when you started riding our bus, because they kicked you off the short bus. Because the retards made fun of you. You're too smart for the slow kids. You're too dumb for the normal kids. You were in your own little category. Smart tards. Folks, this is the guy who orders sushi and sends it back because it's undercooked. He took an IQ test one time and it came back negative. I mean, it's hard to believe that out of millions of sperm, you were the fastest one. But I guess it makes sense. I mean, you're the fastest one because you were carrying one less chromosome. And you know what? Judging from that video, I know your parents loved you right from the start. When he was born, his mother said, "What a treasure." His father said, "Yeah, let's bury it." When you were born, the doctor took one look and slapped your parents. But I'm serious, Nick. You're really special. You're really special, Nick. And I mean that in the Olympic way. And I know high school was tough for you. Never quite, you know, high school was tough for Nick. He never quite fit in through the door. I remember the first time I saw you, man, walking your fat ass down the hall, carrying your big instrument. It's the first time I saw a tuba carrying a tuba. I mean, normally when I roast a pig, it has an apple in its mouth. But you know what? I'm real happy to see you in a committed relationship with Sandra. I really am. I know your lazy eye. I know your lazy. Hey, I got more lazy eye jokes, so hold on, folks. All right. No, I'm really happy to see you in a community relationship because I know, you know, in the past, you know, your girlfriends thought you were seeing someone else on the side. I mean, it's not your fault. I mean, you were, but you can't help that. You have a lazy eye. I mean. And I know, you know, Nick had to leave his last three jobs due to illness. His bosses got sick of him. Nick, you've been canned more than tuna. All right, well, you know what? I have to say I'm very proud. You've been tortured and abused all night. I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to that poor chair you're sitting in. All right, lastly, I just want to say thank you for being a good sport, Nick. I only talk shit to you because I love you, man. I always got your back no matter what, and that's a big fucking back, all right? So you better give me some fucking props. All right, man, happy birthday, man. I love you, buddy.
Everybody give a round of applause for Martin. God dang. Man, that 1,000 pages, fucking shit. He fucking blew Nick out the fucking water. When Nick takes a shit, never mind. Hey, fuck you, you cockeyed, one-eyed motherfucking bitch. Oh, shit. My fucking soundboard. Sorry, technical difficulties. Fuck you, you fucking one-eyed cocksucker motherfucking Nick bitch white bastard. Okay, now we do have one more roaster. He's been lurking in the shadows. This is actually, we're live from Oscar's Creativity Workshop. Everybody give a round of applause for Oscar the Fish Hernandez. Oscar, 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 roo, 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 roo. Here, Oscar. Uh-oh. It looks like he walked out the fucking back door. Anyways, he's come back. Everybody give this guy the round of applause. He's done a lot of fucking work. Oscar Hernandez.
Nick, can you look at me? One, two. Nick. Happy birthday, come here. Look at me, please look at me. Sorry, I don't want nothing to say to you. Appreciate you, I love you. Happy birthday, that's all I gotta say, that's there it. Go. Sorry.
Everybody, a round of applause for Oscar Hernandez. Hold on, I got a tear in my eye. Hold on. That was so fucking emotional, Nick. You crying motherfucker. Shit. Anyways, Oh, shit. I think that concludes our roast. Nick, well, you know what? We have one more. Well, he got the rebuttal now. Nick Rogers, you have the floor. Everybody give Nick Rogers.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. To everybody, thank you very much. I did not know this was a birthday bash or roast whatsoever. This was my effing idea. But overall. No, because when I see you and Joe, you're like flies to me. You ain't shit. Bobby over here, he's the boy. Oscar over there, he's my man. J-Pac, Tupac, Oh, he's bullshit. But, babe, I love you. You're in a doghouse with me, and we got to talk. Yeah. Oh. All right. Anyhow, I just want to say thank you very much for showing up here at Oscar. This is his place, and I'm overwhelmed. This is a big surprise, and thank you very much. Now on that, and thank you again for the birthday. This is overwhelming. I don't know. I'm speechless right now. Thank you, everybody. Joe, Hector, Bobby, Martin, Joel, Oscar, Anita, Sage, Nanny, my babe, Yvette, Frankie, bitch, Robert, what's your name? I'm sorry. You, Robert's wife, Gabby, everybody, thank you very much. This is from the bottom of my heart. I love y'all.
Hey, bitch, you're supposed to roast everybody, motherfucker. We just talk shit. Ah, what a fucking pussy.
Your ass is mine next year, fucker. I see you next year.
I would like all the people that roasted Nick up here, because Nick does have the opportunity to roast everyone at least once. So, Frank and Dolores, please get up here.
No, I'm not doing a roasting. No,
that's you know, you can roast us by saying nice things.
This is all good, man. This is all good. Give me a hug.
Come at me.
I'm glad we, hey, girl, I'm glad that you finally kicked his ass to the curb. That's what I'm talking, boo.
How about all of us now, us just sing happy birthday to the roast boy?
Yeah.
All right. Let's hit this. One. Are you in this? You roasted him with us. What are you talking about, Missy? We always gotta have one woman in the roast. Okay. One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Nick. Happy birthday to you.
We love you, brother.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
All right. I think that concludes the Royal Roast of 2014 of Nicholas Charles motherfucking bitch-ass Rogers. See y'all next week, bitches.
Yo, that was a good roast about my boy Joe, you motherfucker! You went behind him in life, god damn it! Hey, check it out. Hey, there's an upcoming cook-off that's coming up the week. Hold on, I'm running out of speeches right now, just can't get it out. All right. Hey. Let's check this out. There's a cookout coming up in May. It's the first week of that weekend. And it's going to be by Dolby High School of Tallbass Park. Sasha and I will find out more details, but I think the tickets are going to be like, actually the wristbands are going to be like $20. Like $10 a person. So I'll find out more about it. But also check this out too. Not only we're going to not do it just once, not twice this year, we're gonna do motherfucking three times this year. We're doing three times. No, I'm talking about the cook-off. Seriously, in my group out of control, we're gonna do it. Not just one, twice, but three times. For real. So I'll let y'all know what stuff's going down. You know what I mean? So y'all there? Y'all down? Holla, this boy here, the NIC. Peace and motherfucking ease! And that's the bottom line. Cause Stone Cold next to Rogers. Said so. Play my motherfucking music.
You suck, dude.
Nick, English only, please. English only.